Today we are going to be learning about gears, where they are used in our everyday life, such as in the cars that are on our roads, and how we can use gears to change the speed of our solar car. This video is a continuation of the video, How to Build a Solar Car, where we built a solar car which converted energy provided from the sun to mechanical motion. In our investigation into the car's gears, we will be working with the car's electric motor, which converts electricity into mechanical motion, seen here, and the gears, seen here, which transfer the rotational mechanical energy from the electric motor shaft to the car's front axle, making the wheels turn. Additionally, we have one spare gear, which is used in order to change the gearbox arrangement within the solar car. Additionally, we will need an Allen key, a set of pliers, and a screwdriver. Here we have two gears, a small gear and a large gear, which together form a gear train. Gears are comprised of equally spaced teeth which can engage with the teeth on other gears, enabling the smooth transmission of rotational mechanical energy. The following key terms are important when describing the operation of gears. A gear's radius, which is the distance from the centre of the gear to the end of the gear. For example, we can see that gear 1 has a bigger radius than gear 2. The angular velocity is how fast a particular gear spins. Torque is the amount of force that causes an object to rotate. For example, if I were to push here on this gear with a certain amount of force, at a point that is a radius of length away from the gear's point of rotation, I have created a torque on the gear which is equal to that force multiplied by that radius. Let's take a look at how this works in the solar car's default gearbox setting. The electric motor turns the pink gear. This pink gear then turns gear number 1. Gear number 1 then turns gear number 2. And we can see the difference in radius size between the interconnected rotating parts of gear number 1 and gear number 2. Then we can see gear number 2 turning gear number 3. Then gear number 3 is secured to the shaft with a nut, providing the rotational mechanical energy to the wheels. In this default setting, the final gear does not rotate with the other gears, but instead only acts as a spacer to help prevent the components in the gearbox from moving side to side. We will look at two different gearbox settings, noting that since we are not changing the amount of power coming from the electric motor, if you increase the speed of the car's wheels, you will have to decrease the torque, and vice versa. This is explained further at the end of the video. Setting 1 will have a higher speed but lower torque. This setting is best for drag races on the flat. Setting 2 will have a lower speed but a higher torque. This setting is best for getting the car up a hill. By default, the gearbox will be in setting 1, the faster setting. Today I'll show you how to change this to setting 2, the setting stronger for climbing hills. We will begin by removing the electric motor's wire connections to the PCB. Then, we will remove the screws, nuts and washers that hold the electric motor to the main solar car body. We then remove the wheels. We remove the three screws that are currently holding together the car's gearbox, electric motor and shaft. Don't forget our spare gear. It's a good idea to take everything apart to help form a good understanding of each of the different components. Now we begin to assemble the gearbox into its newest setting, putting the gears together like so. We can then close the compartment, being sure to put the electric motor back into the compartment. Then, we close the compartment by putting in the three screws again. With the wheels in place, we can try putting this back on the car. However, we can see that one of the wheels will touch the main body of the car. Therefore, we need to change where the shaft is orientated. Spinning the shaft, you'll be able to find a nut that is holding the shaft on to the gearbox. Therefore, loosening this, we can get free movement along the shaft. Once we have found the middle, we can tighten this back up. and we can see that this will now nicely be placed on the car without any of the wheels touching. Then, using the screws, nuts and washers that we left aside, we can put the electric motor and gearbox combination back onto the solar car. Don't forget to reattach the electric wires of the motor. Have fun racing! Now let's look at some more gear equations. Power, in general, is a measure of the amount of energy over a time period. In our example, when we are talking about gears, power is the angular velocity of the gear multiplied by the torque of the gear. For gears, we have two very important relationships. The first, for two gears with given radiuses and angular velocities, the angular velocity multiplied by the radius for each of the gears is equal. Therefore, when you have two gears rotating together, the larger gear will rotate more slowly. Secondly, since we are only moving the power from one gear to the other, we are not creating or losing any power. Therefore, power is conserved and is equal for each of the gears. Therefore, when you have two gears rotating, the larger gear will rotate more slowly, but will have a higher torque. So overall, by running two gears together of different sizes, we are able to change the speed of rotation and the torque.
Back to work.